For Liberal MPs, an Eastbourne conference day begins before breakfast and ends in the early hours when they meet to review the last and plan the next 24 hours of an all-important week. A party conference is a media showcase, and with the other parties out of the pool, a chance to dominate the political limelight fought for at Westminster. So in grand five-star fashion, cocktails and canapés are sandwiched between discussions and debates.
I'd like to try to explain and persuade you to support.
One of the resort's bed and breakfast customers, MP for Southwark and Bermondsey and hero of the grassroots and Greens, Simon Hughes, split with Steele but ended up on the winning side of a damaging divide on defence. His conference diary would frighten an insomniac.
It's about the busiest week of the year. It's the one week when I give up my time, as it were, to the party activists to reward their work for me. And I think there are 25 speaking commitments that I've got from Sunday evening to Friday evening.
And provide the support system at the...
He needs a minder to steer him between lunchtime, tea time and nighttime fringe meetings on topics as diverse as nuclear power and teenage pregnancy.
And I'm well aware also as to the importance of the issue, having spent 7 years as a youth leader on the Old Kent Road immediately before I was elected.
Back in the conference hall, not all debates are as dramatic, not all speeches as crucial as those that dominated today's headlines and damaged alliance unity on defence.
Many of us joined this party because of its aim and its goal, a non-nuclear Europe in a non-nuclear world.
A downhearted David Steele had to watch an upbeat Simon Hughes swing conference away from a Polaris replacement towards a non-nuclear defence strategy.
We must be determined that our young people, our children and our grandchildren have a non-nuclear world to inherit. We're on the verge of responsibility. There's no more important subject. The battle is not between us. The battle is for our future. I urge you to accept both amendments and the resolution and be proud of all that we stand for.
He won a standing ovation, but by stepping out of line with his leader, did he stamp on his own political career?
Well, Simon Hughes' political career in the Liberal Party is determined by 80,000 people in Southwark and Bermondsey, and only them. I think it may cause, and I regret obviously that it may cause, some immediate problems, but I actually believe that it will cause, on the issue of defence, which is where the controversy lay, a better policy to emerge in the next couple of months.
In the aftermath of the defence debate, David Steele was today rewriting his big speech for Friday to include a lecture on political realism. But at a conference that's brought Cyril Smith back into the Liberal fold, defence rebel Hughes is unlikely to be out in the cold for long, and there's always another fringe meeting.
And then what we seek to do...
David Bellin in Eastbourne for Thames News.
That's why this topic...